In this video, we are going to talk about the difference between trading and investing. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. Some of the links in this article are affiliate links, a link with a special tracking code. This means if you click on an affiliate link and purchase the item, we will receive an affiliate commission. The price of the item is the same whether it is an affiliate link or not. Regardless, we only recommend products or services we believe will add value to our readers. By using the affiliate links, you are helping support our website, and we genuinely appreciate your support. Some assets stuff you own that generates income are better vehicles for investing, others fare better in trading, while a few can both be traded and invested at the same time. Investing and trading are closely related terms. Knowing the difference is key to positioning yourself to a better advantage. Just the nuggets. Investing is putting something of value to an asset today in exchange for higher returns in the future. Investors capitalize on longer time horizons. There are two types of investing, passive investing and active investing. Trading is the act of buying and selling assets frequently. Traders capitalize on market volatility, the ever-present price fluctuations in the market. Traders can be categorized as market timers, sentimental traders, and noise traders. If you want to earn more, then you have to begin specializing in either trading or investing. Determining which one is better than the other depends on your strengths. The basics of investing. Investing is putting something of value to an asset today in exchange for higher returns in the future. Like delayed gratification, you might feel like putting your money into unguaranteed assets as a sacrifice. But in investing, you are capitalizing on money and time. The longer you wait, the greater your returns would be. Suitable assets for investing are bonds, index funds, mutual funds, stocks, and real estate. Bonds are loans you give to government bodies or corporations for a fixed amount of time. On the maturity date, you'll receive a guaranteed return of the initial amount you've invested plus the interest rate. Stocks entitle shareholders to partial ownership and are issued by corporations as a way of raising capital. Index funds consist of stocks of large to mega-cap companies having a huge influence on or used as a benchmark for the general market trend. Mutual funds are pools of diversified funds, collected from several investors under the control of a fund manager, that may be invested in a mix of stocks and bonds. Real estate includes properties like apartments, condominiums, building spaces, pieces of land, and many more. All of these assets may grow with time. Even if the market goes up and down now and then, investors are steadfast with their assets while they ride out the fluctuations. In the long run, letting your investments grow will build strong roots for a fail-proof financial foundation. Types of investing. Number 1. Passive investing. It's the kind of investing that depends on the performance of an index. An index, like the S&P 500 and Dow Jones Industrial Average, is a group of large companies that are used to measure or benchmark market performance. Passive investors have little to no interest in outperforming the market. When the market is down, their investments also go down, and vice versa. Number 2. Active investing. If you want to be more hands-on with your assets, you can pick your stocks, for example. You may outperform the market, giving you more returns. But it's also possible to underperform. If you're going to choose a fund manager, go with someone who knows the fundamentals as well as the technical analysis to strategize the right time of buying and selling. The basics of trading. Trading is the act of buying and selling assets. Now, you may think trading is a prerequisite to investing, since to invest, you must buy the asset first then sell it eventually after a time horizon, e.g. 10 years. While this may sound logical in the world of assets, however, people refer to trading when buying and selling happen frequently. Traders capitalize on market volatility, the ever-present price fluctuations in the market. Suitable assets for trading are stocks, cryptocurrencies, forex instruments, and real estate. Forex instruments could be options, futures, forwards, etc. Foreign exchange is the trading of money currencies around the world. Cryptocurrency can be seen as a modern version of foreign exchange. It works like forex, only this time, the money is digital and outside any influence from governments or private entities. Stocks and real estate also work well with trading, aside from investing. For stocks, traders strategize the right time of buying and selling by looking at the price fluctuations in the market. For real estate, traders buy properties, increase their value, e.g. renovation, then sell them immediately. This process is called flipping, and it can occur in months. Categories of traders, market timers. With the use of technical analysis, market timers strategize the right time to buy or sell the asset for multiple gains. Some examples of market timers are: scalp trader trades assets in a matter of seconds or minutes. Day trader trades assets within the market trading day. Oftentimes, they don't hold assets overnight. Swing trader trades assets in a span of weeks or months. Position trader trades assets after a few months or even a few years. Sentiment traders. Wherever the hype is, expect the sentiment traders to follow suit. Sentiment traders love to participate in the trend. As soon as the wave starts to build, they are in a haste to join the herd to ride the momentum. Noise trader. They usually hang out in social groups for traders. They lurk and stay vigilant for current events and how other traders would behave consequently. Most noise traders are impulsive beginners who will take anyone's opinion into action. They can be as volatile as the stock market's prices. Strength lies in the difference. If you want to earn more, then you have to begin by choosing between trading and investing. People will more likely find their success when they channel all their focus to one particular endeavor. Specialization will help you build strength as you master the culture and rules of the potential learning ground. What do you think of our list? Which thing you like the most? Investing or trading? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.